Now we will look at one previously asked coding problem. This problem was asked in Wipro selection process. The problem statement is, write a program to find the sum of contiguous subarray within a one-dimensional array of numbers which has the largest sum. So this is a very well-known problem in computer science. It is known as largest subarray sum problem. Before discussing the solution, if any one of you don't know the meaning of the term contiguous subarray, let us first discuss that. So subarray means the section or part of the array. For example, if we have our array as 3, 4, 9, 7, then in this case 3, 4 is separate subarray, 3, 4, 9 is separate subarray, 4, 9 is separate subarray, in the same way whole 3, 4, 9, 7 is also separate subarray, and so on and so forth. There can be many such subarrays for this array. Now note here that 3, 9, even though it is a subarray, this is not contiguous subarray, alright, because we have omitted the number 4 here. So this is not contiguous, and we need to find such contiguous subarrays. So 3, 9 is not contiguous, but 3, 4, 9 will become contiguous subarray. Same way 4, 9 is also contiguous subarray. Okay, so I hope you have understood the meaning of the term contiguous subarray. We have to find largest such subarray sum. Okay, now we will turn our focus to solution of the problem. So if all the elements of array are positive, like in this case, that is 3, 4, 9, 7, solution is pretty obvious that largest subarray sum will be sum of all elements. So in this case, largest subarray sum will be 3 + 4 + 9 + 7, that is 23. This was pretty straightforward. But the tricky part is, even if one of the elements of array is negative, so what we have to do if one element is negative, one or more elements are negative, we have to come up with a different approach. Now we will consider case of array consisting of negative elements by taking a separate example. Suppose we have one dimensional array, -1, -2, 5, 0, -1, 2, 6, and -2. Alright, if we apply our previous approach here, the sum of all these elements is 7. Okay, but just by overlooking this array, we can see this subarray 2, 6, which has subarray sum as 8. Now, we don't know whether 8 is indeed a largest subarray sum, but we definitely know that 8 is greater than 7. So it is clear that we cannot apply our previous strategy here. We have to come up with different solution. So the first thing which comes to mind is applying a brute force solution. Now, what is brute force solution? We consider all the contiguous subarrays. We find the sum for all contiguous subarrays, and within that, whichever sum will be maximum, we will print that sum as our answer. For example, we will start considering subarrays from -1. So -1, -2 will be first subarray, whose sum will be -3. After that, -1, -2, 5, whose sum will be 2. And similarly, we will carry forward till the last element of the array. After considering all the elements starting with all the subarrays starting with -1, we will consider subarrays starting with -2. So -2, 5 will be first subarray, whose sum will be 3. After that, -2, 5, 0, and till the end of the array. Now we will do this procedure for rest of the elements of array as well. Alright, so after considering all the subarrays, we will find that this particular subarray, that is 5, 0, -1, 2, 6, has the largest subarray sum, and that is 12. No other subarray has sum as large as 12. So brute force solution will definitely work. But there is one problem related to brute force solution. Can you guess that problem? The problem is that if our array consists of n elements, then the total number of contiguous subarray for that array will be n × n+1/2. Alright. So the time complexity will become big O of n square. Now if the value of n is very large, then our program will definitely exceed the time limit. So the program will not work. So we have to check if there exists an efficient solution. Alright, So, is there any smart approach for solving this problem now? As it turns out, there exists efficient solution. Now, remember that we have our largest subarray sum is 50-126, whose sum is 12. Note here that we have included this number -1 in our subarray even though it is negative. Now, why we have included -1? Because by including -1, we can combine these two groups, that is 50 and 26 together. Note that our subarray has to be contiguous, so including -1 is must. So only after including -1 we can combine this whole subarray together and its sum will become 12. So we can include negative elements if they are connecting the groups of two positive numbers. All right. But what in this case, that is 5, -3, -4 and 100. So we will consider each subarray separately. First, if our subarray is 5, I will write sum here. When subarray is 5 only, sum will be 5, of course. After that, our subarray will become 5, -3, whose sum will become 2. After that, our subarray will become 5, -3 and -4. Okay, now sum will become -2. Now note here that whole subarray sum is getting negative. Okay, so whole subarray sum is getting negative, and even after the next term is positive, that is next term is 100, sum will become, let me write here first, 5, -3, -4 and 100. Now sum in this case will become 98. But if we consider 100 separately, that is 100 as separate subarray, its sum will be 100. So 98 is less than 100. So we can say that whenever the whole subarray's sum goes negative, like -2 in this case, we have to stop considering that subarray further. So there is no point in considering this subarray 5, -3, -4 any further, even if next terms are positive, because the overall sum will be less. We will formalize our observations in a 5-step algorithm. So this 5-step algorithm is written here. First step is take two variables, current sum and max sum, and we have to initialize both of them to 0. I have initialized them both of them to 0 here. Alright, second step is we have to iterate through all elements of array by using for loop or while loop, any loop can work. Third step is add current element to current sum. So whenever we will visit every element in the array while iterating, we have to add that current element to our variable current sum. Alright, so when we will visit -1, we will add -1 to current sum. When we will be visiting -2, we will add -2 to current sum, and so on and so forth. Now there are two important conditions related to our variables current sum and max sum. First of these conditions is, if current sum is less than 0, we have to set it back to 0. Okay, so let's take this first element, that is -1. When we add -1 to current sum will also become -1. Now -1 is negative, that is it is less than 0. So we have to set this -1, that is current sum, back to 0. And the last condition is, if current sum is greater than max sum at any stage, we have to set max sum is equal to current sum. Okay, so this is very obvious, that is why the variable's name is max sum. So whenever current sum overtakes max sum, we have to update max sum as well. Now we will apply this algorithm on our above example. Before applying, let me just clarify that after iterating through all the elements of array, whatever will be the value of max sum will be our final answer for largest subarray sum. Alright, so now let us apply this algorithm on our above example. So here I have already initialized our both variables current sum and max sum to 0. Now we are iterating through all elements of array. Our first element is -1. So after adding -1 to current sum, according to our third step in the array, we have to add current element to current sum. So we will add -1 to 0, current sum will become -4. Now note that according to our fourth step in the algorithm, if current sum is less than 0, we have to set it back to 0. Now in this case, -1 is less than 0, so we will set my current sum back to 0. Alright, now current sum is 0 and
our max sum is also 0 here. Here is our max sum. So current sum and max sum both are 0. So there is no need to update max sum right now. Okay. So our next element in the array is minus 2. Again, according to our third step, we will add current element to current sum. So current sum will become minus 2 plus 0. That is minus 2. Again, according to our fourth step in algorithm, if current sum is less than 0, we have to set it back to 0. So minus 2 is indeed less than 0. So we will set current sum back to 0. Again, there is no need to update max sum. Now next element is 5. We will add 5 to current sum. Current sum will become 5 plus 0. That is 5. Now note here that our current sum is 5 and our max sum is 0. So according to our fifth step in algorithm, if current sum is greater than max sum, we have to update max sum as current sum. Alright, so we will update max sum as 5 here. So the next element in the array now is 0. Now 0 is not harmful for us. Current sum will become 0 plus 5 as 5 only, and now there is no need to update max sum. Now next element is minus 1. Current sum will become minus 1 plus 5, that is 4. Now note here, our current sum is 4 and our max sum is 5. So max sum is greater than current sum, so there is no need to update max sum at this stage. Next element is 2. We will add 2 to current sum. 2 plus 4 will become 6. Now our current sum 6 is greater than our max sum, so we will update our max sum to 6. After that, next element in the array is 6. Current sum will become 6. No, rather current sum will become 6 plus 6, that is 12. And again, we will have to update our max sum now. So max sum will also become 12. And the last element of the array, that is minus 2. Now current sum will become minus 2 plus 12, that is 10. And max sum will remain 12 as it is. Alright, so now we have iterated through all elements of the array, and as you can see, after iterating through all the elements of array, we have found our max sum to be 12. Alright, so 12 will be our largest sub array sum. Okay, and we already know, because of our brute force solution, that is the largest sub array sum of 50 minus 126 is indeed 12. So we can say that our algorithm definitely works.
Now let's look at code for this problem statement. I have written this code in C language. First of all, we are taking input for size of the array, and after that input for all the elements of array. As mentioned in the algorithm, we have taken two elements, two variables, current sum and max sum, and initialized both of them to 0. After that, we are iterating through all elements of array. While visiting every element, we are adding that element to current sum variable. So current sum is equal to current sum plus array of I. If at any stage our current sum value is greater than max sum, then we are setting max sum as current sum. And at the same time, if our current sum is less than 0 at any stage, then we are setting current sum back to 0. Okay, so after iterating through all the elements of array, at the end we are just printing that largest sum array sum is the value of our max sum variable. Alright, so let me just zoom out a little bit. These particular lines of code is our logic for this problem. So let's run this problem now. Our input is size of array is 8, and these are elements of array. If I just run this program now, let's wait for the output. As you can see, the output is largest subarray sum is 12. So program works correctly. Now one more thing, guys. If our array consists of all the negative elements, example in this case, that is minus 4, minus 2, minus 6, minus 9, then according to our algorithm, the answer will be 0. But zero number is not present in the array itself. So one might wonder that this is giving a wrong answer. So we can handle this case by some very little modification. We can
make our maxim variable as minimum value of integer. Now what is this int min? This int min is basically present in the limits.h library. So it is the minimum number of minimum value of integer in C language. Okay, so we have just initialized maxim as int min so that we can handle the case of array having all negative elements also. So if I run this input now, that is -4, -2, -6 and -9, and I clicked run, waiting for output. As you can see, the largest subarray sum is -2. So this is our program for the problem statement. I hope you have understood this program. So that's all about this largest subarray sum problem. Remember, this problem was asked in Wipro selection process. Before signing off, just one more question, guys. What if we have to print whole subarray with largest sum? So now what we are printing as output is just the value of largest subarray sum. So in this case, we were printing just 12 as our answer. But what if we have to print whole subarray also? So what if our answer is of the form 50-1 26? Okay, we have to print all these elements also. So what we can do to achieve this output? If anyone of you can answer this question in comment section below, we will really appreciate that. Apart from this, if you have any programming related query or query related to this particular problem, feel free to ask that in the comment section. We will respond to each and every query. Moreover, if you want code for this particular problem statement, I will make sure that I will upload it on Talent Battle website. Do check there. So that's it from my end, guys. I hope you got to learn something from this video. For more such placement related videos, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.